time is it? You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button. You know just where it's at. Right down there. Right down there. And it's time to follow my Instagram. That's Geekly Amanda. G-E-E-K-L-Y Amanda. It's the same on Twitter. Make sure to follow me there too. And it's time to get this movie review started. Y'all, 2 days ago, I went to see F9, the Fast Saga. You know, this the ninth sequel to the Fast and Furious. And let me tell you, I thought it was amazing. It was faster. It was more furious. It had more action, more laughs, more, and a heartfelt story. I loved it. Let me first tell you a little bit about what the movie's about this time around. So we know Dom, played by Vin Diesel. He's off living the quiet life with Letty, who's Michelle Rodriguez, you know, and his son. They're living off the grid and just taking it easy, little peaceful life, but they always looking over their shoulder because they always know that danger lurks around the every little corner. And guess what? The crew came back to find them because they got to stop this earth-shattering plot. And in the midst of it all is, you know, Jacob, who is a new character we meet, and it is Dom's brother, who is played by John Cena, you've seen in the trailers, and he's in the mix, so it makes things interesting. The truth is, you know, this is the ninth of the sequel, the Fast and Furious sequel, F9, the Fast Saga, and this movie didn't need to be made. There wasn't no lingering plot holes or anything that they had to, you know, fill in, but I have said it, that this movie is like a love letter. It's like a love letter to the Fast and Furious franchise fans out there. Like I said, it's faster. It's crazier. It's more zanier. Like, there's some crazy stuff that happens. Think of a car going up to space. Yes, they get crazier in this one. They get zanier. They get more outrageous. And it makes for a good movie. Like I said, John Cena is this one. I'm gonna tell you, that was a brilliant move to bring John Cena in this. He shined on screen. He had the personality and the charisma. And I'm gonna tell you, I'm be honest, he outshined even Vin Diesel when on screen, out-acted him, which that's not too hard to do. Charlize Theron is back in this one as Cypher, the woman who killed his, you know, Dom's baby's mama. I don't know what it is about Charlize Theron, but I just think something magical happens when she's in these villain roles. Like, I don't know if it's maybe the beauty. Like, she has this, I've seen her in person. She has this stunning beauty that just will mesmerize you. So on top of this beauty that you just want to stare at, and then she's a great actress. So she gets down in these villainous roles where she just exudes that evilness on top of the beauty. It's just like a work of art when you see her in these villain roles. And I loved it. I loved her in this. Although we didn't get to see too much of her in this one, but enough for me to fall in love with her all again. Yes, girl crush. And like I said, we have Dom's crew back, two of them who's played by Ludacris and Tyrese Gibson. They were there for the comedy. They had me cracking up with their comedic little quips and whips back and forth to each other and little, they will drop a line and have you cracking up like in a second. And it needed it because I feel like if this had a great balance of like the comedy, which would sometimes take away just from the outrageousness of it. You know, some of these cars are put into situations that just aren't believable, you know, over the top, where in any other movie you'd be like, this is just stupid. But in this one, no. Maybe it was director Justin Lin who had, you know, directed some of the previous sequels of this movie. I think his most recent was the Fast and Furious 6, and he's back, so he knows these movies, which, you know, having that under your belt, the knowledge of it, he does a great job also of just balancing all the outrageousness with a lot of the melodrama. If I had any complaint about this movie, it would be the length. 2.5 hours long. Why? Why do they want to do this with me? That's too long. I got stuff to do. I mean, you can almost only get so much drama and crazy car chasing. They had a new character introduced, one you had never heard of, so they had to give, you know, plenty of backstory on that character. But still, 2.5 hours long, too much. Too much, Hollywood. Pay attention. I've been seeing this for a while. Stop making these lengthy movies. We don't need it. You could get a good movie in within 2 hours or under. So we're tired of it. Let's discuss the parents' review and what parents need to know before letting their kids go see F9, The Fast Saga. So as far as language, I mean, you're going to get some harsh language. They have some profanity all throughout it. You're going to get the S word, the B word, you know, the A word, the dumbass word, you know. What else? They had hell, prick, stuff like that. I kept waiting to hear the F word because I was like, let me make my notes. Did they? And never dropped the F word. So I was like, well, y'all trying to do a little something for the parents over here, Fast and Furious 9. You're trying to do a little something by keeping it not too harsh of language. No F words, but you get the others in there sprinkled in. As far as mature content, I mean, this is Fast and Furious. You're going to get car chases. You're going to get shootouts which lead to death. I mean, we already discussed, you know, some deaths of babies' mamas, which may trigger some people. There's other murders and theft and robberies and all of that stuff. So this is online with all the other Fast and Furious movies, if you've seen this as far as mature content. They had some drinking. Of course, Dom likes his Corona beers. No nudity or sex involved. Like I said, I enjoyed it. It was fun. It was a fun movie to watch. It also had the heartfelt story thrown in there, which was about family. Don has a new brother, you know, our brother we never heard of, new to us. So you're going to get some familyness in there. And all the stuff that you love in the Fast and Furious plus some. It's coming in theaters Friday, June 25th. I suggest seeing it on the big screen because seeing those car chases and explosions, all that in the big screen, you can't compare that to watching it on your TV at home. You can't. So if you've seen it, let me know what you think. If you're excited to see it, I want to know too. Comments, thumbs, all that. Until next time, mwah, bye.